We begin now the 12th parak of Meseches Shabbos, parak Habona. This is Shabbos Daf Kuf Beis, Amud Beis Shabbos, Daf 102b. The Mishnah says, Habona, when somebody builds, Kama Yivne V'yehei Chayev, how much does the person have to build in order to be Chayev for building on Shabbos? Habona Kolshu, if a person builds any amount, that's the person is Chayev for the Malach of Bona on Shabbos. V'hamisates, Misates is somebody who carves out a stone into the right shape or the right size. Rashi says, Misates Merabes HaEven U'Misakna HaKol Lefi HaMokom. You make it square according to each, according to his place, how they make their stones. Sheyesh makomos sheragil and lahachlik. Some have smooth stones. Sheyesh makomos sheragil and lahachlik. Bacharitzim, charitzim, beretz Ashkenaz, places in Germany. They would make, they would carve lines into the stones, different ways of making them. That's mesates. V'hamaka bepatish. What's maka bepatish? Rashi says, gam hum b'avos melachos. This is one of the 39 avos melachos v'belaz fiksha mefutzitz bo eso evan min asela. La'achash ha'chotzav eso evan sovav v'mavdil min ahar k'tzas. When you're trying to separate the stone from the mountain or from the larger rock, you hit with a hammer a large hit. It causes the stone to fall off the mountain. That's the final malacha of people who are carving the stones out of the mountain. Told us, and anybody who finishes a malacha on Shabbos, that is a tolda of makeh v'patish. Uva Matzad, that's like a sledgehammer. Rashi says, Matzad afu kamo kornis gadol shel barzel, labinyan shel barzel. It was a large hammer of iron when you're building something out of iron, essentially a sledgehammer. Hakodeach, somebody who drills. Rashi says, Hakodeach nokev eitzo evan bakosel. You drill a piece of wood, a peg of wood, a stone into a wall. A kolshu chayiv, any amount is chayiv. Rashi says kolshu akulu koy. This goes on all the cases. Amisatis umakav v'patish uvemetzav v'akodech. All of these different cases, versions of either makav v'patish or building, are chayiv b'kolshu. Chayiv, you're chayiv even if you do with a kolshu. Zaklal, here's the rule. Kol osa malacha malachto miskayemis b'shabbos. Anybody who does malacha and it is permanent, it lasts on Shabbos. Chayiv, you're chayiv. Rashi says what that means. Kol osa malacha malachto miskayemis sheyesh miskayemis kayotze bo. They ain't merciful. The way Rashi understands, people would say that this is a final malacha. It wouldn't need any addition to it in any situation like that. You're chayiv. The chayin Rav Shimon Gamliel Lomar af hamakka bekornis al hasadun b'shas malacha. If somebody bangs onto the anvil, takes his hammer and he bangs onto the anvil while he's doing his work on Shabbos, chayiv. He's chayiv mimneshu k'masakin malacha. He's like fixing up his work. Rashi says here mimneshu k'masakin malacha. V'yavav yishenu makal apuula. Even though he's not using the hammer to hit the item which he is creating, El Al Asadan, he's only hitting the hammer against the anvil. That alone can make you chayev of a Gemara Mefarsh Ma'amisakin. The Gemara will explain what is he fixing by taking the hammer and hitting it on the anvil during the work that he's doing. Gemara asks, Kolshu Lamai Chazi, what is the Kolshu building a tiny amount? What is that fit for? Don't you have to do a malacha that is fit for something? Amar Rav Yirmiyah, Rav Yirmiyah says, Shekein Ani Chofer Guma La'atznia Ba Prutosav. A poor person will dig a little hole in the ground in order to hide his money. The Chavasa Gavi Mishkan, we find a similar idea by the Mishkan, Shekein Tofra Yerios, Chofren Guma Lahatznia Ba Machtein, and the people who would stitch up the curtains would dig small holes in the ground to put their needles. So that's the Malacha as we find it in the Mishkan, and that's also the use of the Malacha. Abaya Amar Abaya says, Kevin the Mishtachi Lo Avdi Hachi. If you would bury the needles, they would get rust, and therefore that's not what they did in the Mishkan. Ela Shekein Ani Osa Pitpute Kira Katana. Rather, what it was that the poor people would make a small tripod for their stove, or lishbos ale kader katana, to put a small pot on to cook even the smallest amount of items. To chavas agavi mishkan, we find similarly by the mishkan mevashli samonin letzvoi yerios shechasra malachton. Let's say they had a little bit of curtain left to do, a tiny amount. They would cook up a small amount of dye to dye the curtains. Osin pitpute kira katana. Again, they would make a small tripod for a kira katana, lishbosala yora katana, for a small pot in order to cook the dye. Rav Acha bar Yaakov says to that second answer, ein anios b'makom ashiros. We don't act like we're in poverty when we're in an area of wealth. When it came to the building of the Mishkan, this was they had a lot of resources. It was an area of wealth. You wouldn't try to cook the exact amount of dye that you need for a tiny amount of curtain. Ella, rather, the Gemara gives Rav Acha bar Yaakov gives a third answer. Shekein balabayis sheyesh lo nekev bibiroso. Let's say a balabayis has a hole in his mansion, in his large living quarters. Vesosmo, he's going to close it up. To chavas agavi mishkan, we find similarly by the mishkan. Shekein keresh enough la bodarna. If you have a beam where a worm put a little hole in the beam. Matif lasocha aver, you'll put in a little bit of metal, a little bit of a liquid metal, and seal it up. Vesosmo, and you're going to seal that up. And that's on the contrary. That's b'makom ashiras, right? A person has a bira noa, a person has a nice living quarters. He's going to be worried about even a small hole. And so too by the Mishkan, which was b'makom ashiras, a place of wealth, you're going to be worried even about a small hole in the beams. Amar Shmuel says, ha-metzadeh eso evan chayev, if somebody is metzadeh the evan, which Rashi says means, moshivo metzadeh do ad shemes yasheves bekarkois yisod abinyin yofe. You put it into the ground, well, you settle it into the earth well, you surround it by dirt. That's basically the lowest level of stone that you're putting into a building. That's going to be chayev because you are because you're building. So the Gemara says, Meisvei, the Gemara asks, Echa nosen eso evan vecha nosen es atit. If one person puts the stone down as he's building and then the other person puts down the cement, ha nosen es atit chayev. It's the person who puts down the cement that's chayev. And Shmuel didn't require any cement. Shmuel said if you put the stone in the ground and surround it with earth, that's enough. So the Gemara says, Velatayimich, one second. According to that question, Eim Masefa, look at the safe of that very same Braisa. Rabbi Yossi Omer, Vafilo Hela, Vinyach, Agabi Dimos, Shal Avanim Chayv. Even just putting the stone on the top of the row, let's say the top row of stones, you put the stone on, you don't have to do any setting of the stone, no cement required in your Chayv. So he goes to the other extreme. So the Gemara says, obviously, it depends where you're putting the stone. Ella, rather, Telos of Binyane Havi, there are three different kinds of Binyanim. Tasum, Mitzi of Ila, there's the bottom level, the bottom row of a wall. There's the middle levels, and then there's the top level. Tasa boi tzedude, v'afra. In the bottom level, you need to set it, and you need to surround it by earth. And that's what Shmuel was talking about in his original statement. Mitzia boi namitina. When it comes to the middle levels, of course, you need cement, and that's what the first part of the Braisa was saying. And Eloi, in the upper levels, b'hanocha bi'alma, just simply placing the stone, that is going to be enough to be chayiv. And that's what Rabbi Yossi was talking about at the end of the Braisa. Ba'amisates, so then the Mishnah said the case of misates, which again Rashi explained is mirabeya, so Evan, you're making the stone into the proper shape. So the Gemara says, misates mishomai mechayev. Why is misates chayev? Rav amar misham bona, Shmuel amar misham makabipatish. It's machlokas Rav and Shmuel. Rav says that's the equivalent of building, and Shmuel says that's the equivalent of makabipatish. The Gemara says a similar machlokas. Ha'osa nekev belul shal tarnagolim. Let's say somebody makes a hole in a chicken coop. They used to make the holes over there in order that the smell should come out. So it was in order to let air out. So also the Gemara says later on that sometimes the holes were to let in and out. But whatever the case may be, the person makes this hole in the chicken coop. Rav amar misham bona. Rav says you're chayiv because of building, and the same idea. Shmuel amar misham makav patish. Again, Shmuel says that's a situation of makav patish. Ayel shufsa bekupina demara. Let's say you have they had in a hoe, they had the blade, and there was a hole where you stuck a peg in order to secure the blade. So let's say you stick in that peg, same machlokas. Rav amar misham bona. Rav says again, you're chayiv because of bona. Shmuel amar misham makav patish. Shmuel says in that case, you're chayiv again because of makav patish. Rashi just says here, by the lul shel tarnagolim, I wanted to read this Rashi. Shel etzu, it was made out of wood, v'sosum, and it was sealed completely. U'minakvo sheyotza harech shel tzoa v'lo yazik luhu. The reason why they would make a hole is so that the reach should leave the chicken coop. It wouldn't damage the chickens. That's how Rashi learns. Again, this gets into a whole issue about making a nekev, whether it has to let things in and out or only to let them out. So here Rashi is saying, in this particular Rashi seems to be saying that it's just simply to let out the reach. That's why you're making the hole. Again, this is a discussion in other sugyas within the Masechta. So anyways, we have three cases over here where Rav and Shmuel are arguing about Bona and Makav Patish, and the question is, why do we need all three cases? So the Gemara says, Ritzricha, we need all three cases. Diyashmin and Kamaisa, if we only had the first case, Bahikom Rav Mishum de Derech Binyan Bekach. In that first case where you're carving out the shape of the stone, that's of course, Rav says it's building, that's the way of building. You're actually building something. Avalosa Neked Belo Shal Tarnagolim, but just making a hole in a chicken coop, Dein Derech Binyan Bekach, that's not a normal way of building. Maybe Rav would admit that's makav patish. There you're making it for air that's similar to binyan. Again, it has some kind of similarity to binyan. Rashi says the dummy lebinyan sha'af binyan habatim osim nekovim la'avir. Even when you build a house, you make some holes for air. Kidako amar the avdi la'avira churim v'chalonos. You make for air. You make either holes or windows. You make things like that. So that's why Rav would say over there that it's considered bona. Aval shufsa b'kupina demar, but when it comes to the case of, again, with the fixing the blade to the handle of the hoe, dein derech binyan v'kach, that's completely not a way of binyan. Ema Modele Shmuel. Maybe he would admit to Shmuel that it is Maka Bepatish, and Shmuel just the reverse. V'yashmin b'hab, akamar Shmuel, av b'anachtarti, ema Modele Laraf. Maybe Shmuel only said it by the case of the handle by the hoe, but he wouldn't say it by the other cases. Tzricha, that's why we need them to argue by all three cases, to say in all three cases, Rav says it's Bona, and Shmuel says it's Maka Bepatish. Boy minei Rav Nosson Baroshi, me Rav Yochanan, Rav Nosson Baroshi asked Rav Yochanan, Mesates mishumai mechayev, why is Mesates chayev? Achvi lebiyode mishumaka bepatish. He showed him, he agreed with the position that Mesates is chayev because of Maka bepatish, basically Shmuel's opinion. Vohanon tanan ha Mesates veha Maka bepatish. So the Gemara asks 1 second. But our Mishnah says Mesates and Maka bepatish as if it's two separate things. How could anyone say that Mesates is chayev because of Maka bepatish? Ema, rather, you should read the Mishnah, ha Mesates, ha Maka bepatish. One who is Mesates is chayev because of Maka bepatish. Tashma, the Gemara tries to bring a proof to this issue about Bona versus Maka bepatish, and we'll see that discussion in the next video on Daf Kuf Gimel Amud Aleph.